So you're thinking of moving to beautiful Newport Beach in sunny Orange County, California. Well, in this video, we're going to go on, I'm going to take you on a map tour of Newport Beach. I'm going to take you by four homes, four totally different communities, different price ranges. And you'll certainly want to stick around to the end because we go through a home that's literally on the sand on Balboa Peninsula. And don't forget to check out our Newport Beach vlog, our Newport Beach pros and cons video. We've got a video of the luxury golf course community in Irvine called Shady Canyon. We've got Hidden Canyon. We've got Huntington Beach, Santa Ana. We've got Tustin. We got a lot of videos. Let's get to it. If this is your first time on the channel, welcome. If you want to know everything there is to know about living, working, playing, owning a home in beautiful Orange County, California, Irvine, surrounding communities, become the right channel. Do us a favor, like our videos. Hit the subscribe button, click the bell for notification so we can make you the first to be made aware of the next time we upload a new video on Irvine, California, Newport Beach, Newport Coast, Tustin, Corona. We got a lot of videos coming up. Hi, my name's Bruce Clark. I'm a real estate agent with Coldwell Banker. Been doing this more than 17 years and every day I get phone calls, emails, text messages from people just like you that are looking to make a move to the area. Also looking potentially to sell a home. So whether it's the next 5 days or 50 days or even further out, give us a call. Shoot us a text, send us an email. We would love to help you make a smooth move to Orange County, California, Irvine, California, surrounding communities, Newport Beach, Newport Coast, Corona Del Mar, Huntington Beach. And if you have a home to sell, we'd love to help you there also.
All right, let's talk about Newport Beach on the map. Number one, Newport Beach size, 85 to 86,000 people. It fluctuates about 25 square miles of land. So it's not big, but gosh, there's a lot there. World-class homes, of course, world-class dining, world-class shopping, world-class beaches. Naturally, Newport Beach. So you're bordered by Costa Mesa, Newport Coast. It's Corona Del Mar is in Newport Beach. I'm not really going to go into Newport or Corona Del Mar much today because we're going to have a totally separate video on Corona Del Mar. It's kind of its own little subsection. We'll go over more of that. Some of the homes we're going to take a look at, we're going to talk about some communities right now, some areas. One is Harborview Homes, or the Port Streets, because all the streets are after ports. And one of the homes we're going to go into on our map video is going to be a home on the Port Street. So then you have a wonderful golf course, Big Canyon. Big Canyon is a community, it's a wonderful golf course. As you can see, you know, Burning Tree and some others. One of the neat things that we see in Big Canyon, people are gonna spend $4 to $5 million, certainly even up to $7 million for a home. And a lot of times they're gonna tear it down. They're gonna go take it down to studs, you're gonna renovate, they're gonna totally rehab it. Because these homes are older, but they're in a golf course community, and this is one of the most prestigious, certainly in Newport Beach. Don't forget to watch our map video on Shady Canyon in Irvine. It's an also wonderful, wonderful exclusive golf course community. So this is Fashion Island. We're going to come back to Fashion Island. Let's talk a little bit more, though, about here. This is Dover Shores right here, and there are three streets. I've got to zoom in. There are three streets here. Morning Star, Evening Star, Night Star. You can see them. And they actually have docks. Now, the reason I mention that, not all the homes, of course, you have to be on the water. The reason I mention that is because we're going to go by, one of the homes we went by is on Harbor Island, and Harbor Island Drive. And it has 53 feet of frontage on the water, and it's for $10 million. So you can get into these homes for around $7 to $8 million. So it could save you $2 to $3 million. You can come in, do your own work, and end up with more of a custom home. So this was Dover Shores. Now I'm going to take you through the islands here in just a minute, but I wanted to go over a few more things. And so this is Fashion Island, as I mentioned. As we're heading down this way, we've got Irvine Terrace, and we have some other places. We didn't go any homes in Irvine Terrace, nor did we go Cameo Shores, Cameo Highlands, as you get, again, Corona Del Mar. We didn't go to Corona Del Mar. Separate video. There weren't many homes available. But here we go. Here's a yacht club. I'll show you that. And Pacific Coast Highway, which we've seen often. South, Laguna Beach. North, Huntington Beach. South, First, you're going to hit Corona del Mar. Then you're going to hit Newport Coast. You're going to be going into Crystal Cove. And then, again, continuing south, you're going to hit Laguna Beach and then all the other cities that you're going to have that way. So, and this way is Huntington Beach. So you're going to go, you've got Seal Beach. You've got some others. So that's Pacific Coast Highway. How do you get to Newport from Irvine? One would be Jamboree. Jamboree takes you directly on to Balboa Island, which I'm going to show you here in just a minute. So another way is a 55. 55 freeway comes all the way down. It's right here. Comes down to PCH. You can continue coming down 55. Now we take the 55 as we head to Huntington Beach. So there's the exit off 55. So again, 55 brings you all the way down to as you can see, boom. PCH is there. By Newport Beach Pier. So just a few. Now there's also some other communities. You have One Ford Road, you have Bell Court, you have some others. I didn't want to go through every single one, Santa Ana Heights, but I wanted to kind of give you an overview. There's a public golf course, and I have a link to that. A lot of places that we're talking about, we're going to have links to. One of the things that we did was we filmed I call them intros, and we filmed it right around here. This is the upper Newport Bay Nature Preserve. There's a trail. It's about 10 miles. You can see, good walking. Really nice. So you can drive this also. We drove some of it. Vista Point, if you watch our pros and cons video, because we record it from Vista Point, which is in Upper Newport Bay. So very cool. Let's talk about the islands, and then we're going to talk about beaches. So there's multiple islands, and so you have Collins Island, which is really small. There's the least number of homes there. It's really cool. It's a walkway. Bay Island. You cannot drive onto Bay Island. It's all that. Balboa Island, we're going to come back to. We have Lido Island, very exclusive. It's some big boats. Lido Island, a little bigger. So we call those the islands. You have Linda Isle, so you can see. And then you have the marina. You have the resort. Balboa Bay Resort. Wonderful, wonderful rooms, wonderful staff, excellent food. We've stayed there. We had my wife is a member of she's a ambassador for the Hispanic Chamber of Commerce. And they had a wonderful event there and very impressed. Really, really enjoyable. So you have the islands, Balboa Island. And where's Balboa Island connect to? Balboa Island. Again, you can Jamboree ends. But what's neat is you can take the ferry across to Balboa Peninsula. Sorry, there's Balboa Pier. So Balboa Pier, a nice municipal park there. And then you've got Balboa Peninsula, as you can see. Now, you can take the ferry from Balboa Peninsula to Balboa Island or vice versa. You can drive off of Balboa Peninsula. It's not an island. There's only one way. There's two ways, the ferry, and then there's only one street that leads off of Balboa Island. As you can see, Balboa Island's much smaller. Balboa Peninsula is huge, and you can drive off of it, but it's huge. Down here is the wedge. Let me talk about that for a second. We're going to talk about some swimming and some other, surfing and things. The wedge, phenomenal surf, one of the most dangerous surf places in the world. Virtually every year, surfer dies there. Not somewhere you would swim. The waves are too high. The undertow, the cross currents, would definitely not recommend. But it's cool to come down here. And one of the homes we look at is right down here, as a matter of fact. And it pretty much overlooks the wedge. This is the jetty, as you can see. This is the canal. This is where you're going to take your boat. Your boat's going to come out there. Boom. You know, whale watching. You know, I've done ocean kayaking. Yeah, I did that for a year and did some racing. And to get out there, and it's just so cool. Again, we're not going to really go much into Corona del Mar today. But I want to give you a nice little top-down view. So, good places to swim. Balboa Peninsula has great swimming. The waves break late. In other videos, I've probably been a bit harsh because the waves crash so late. So unless you're a good swimmer or there's lifeguards, I wouldn't really recommend a lot of swimming there until you get closer to the pier. I should have mentioned that earlier. Closer to the pier, the waves aren't as high, and there's a lot more people, and it's a good place. But again, as you're getting over this way, it's tougher. Phenomenal beaches. Oh my gosh, I used to live on Balboa Peninsula. I love Balboa Peninsula, and there's a lot to do. There's some great nightlife there. You can see you've got all kinds of, the fun zone. I'll talk about that in a second. I'm gonna have links to a lot of things. So anyway, swimming, you can go to Newport Beach, you can go to the pier on both sides of the pier. You've got Balboa Peninsula. Balboa Island is for walking around. You're really not gonna do much. You are going to go to Corona del Mar. They have phenomenal beaches. They have a state beach. You can go to China Cove. Yeah, all kinds of things. So all kinds of neat things to do. Balboa Island is fun to go to. They have nice little restaurants. They have a wonderful candy store there that we get. And, taffy, that's what it is. We make taffy there. And so wonderful. Mentioned, you got the yacht club. We used to take our kayaks out of the right by the yacht club. And it's really cool. And so we used to do the channel and even head out to the ocean. Did some races. Fun. So that's kind of the top down of what you're looking at here. Let me switch over here. Let's talk about some food. Absolutely phenomenal food. You've got lots of restaurants. I'm going to go over this is still Fashion Island, not go to that. The Hyatt Regency, world-class hotel. There's some other nice hotels. Mm-hmm. Over here off the one, you've got a lot of restaurants. As you can see, you've got the Rusty Pelican, you've got Billy's Beach, you've got Louis by the Bay, you've got Guacamigos. Love that name, Guacamigos. So, it's good food. I think the best Mexican food out here is in Santa Ana, and it might even be off a truck. A lot of cool things. So, a lot of things to do and see. You're off Pacific Coast Highway. This is PCH. Oh, sorry about that. There we go. This is all PCH. So, Newport Fun Tours and Rentals. We came down and we did. There's a boat adventures. You can go whale watching. You can go, as you can see, you can rent a boat. We did we rented an electric boat, a Duffy, and cruised around. And so it was really cool. My apologies. The Fun Zone. So we have the Fun Zone on Balboa Peninsula. So let's go back. And what can you do at the Fun Zone? So we've got all kinds of cool things. So at the Fun Zone, what you're going to be able to do, let me take you over there, sorry. So you're going to be able to rent, you can rent boats. They have some jet skis you could rent. You can go whale watching. You can go, Catalina. But they also have really fun, they have a Ferris wheel. So really cool. And all of that's right here. So, very cool stuff. Let's go. This was a few more places for swimming. There's not much there. Park-wise, you got 58 parks. I'm not going to go in depth in parks. Just know there's a lot of them, a lot of things to see and do. Naturally, baseball, basketball. Yeah, they're just all over. Parks, beaches. I have a link here. You have the Newport Pier, Balboa. You have Balboa Peninsula. It's just pretty much just before you actually get to my talk about actually get on the peninsula. But I'm going to have links to all this so you can look at those at your leisure. Now this is a really cool interactive map. What you're going to be able to do here is you're going to be able to go and pick out what you want. If you want a ball diamond, it's going to highlight it. Again, I'm going to have that. Fashion Island, world-class dining. They have movies, shopping. There's really nothing you're not going to be able to find close by. Not only do you have Fashion Island, you can go into South Coast Plaza in Costa Mesa in about 20 minutes. You can be within a half hour. You can be at Irvine Spectrum, which is, again, millions and millions of square feet of space to shop and eat and all kinds of things. So good restaurants, excellent restaurants, as a matter of fact. Not just good. At Fashion Island, Cheesecake Factory, you've got Javier's, you've got Fleming's Steak, So Hop Daddy, all kinds of things. My apologies. Javier's is down at Corona Del Mar. And also Javier's is also at Spectrum. My apologies. Hop Daddy Burger Bar. Ooh, good burgers. Sit down bar. But it's tough to be in and out and have a burger out here. But as you can see, lots of restaurants. P.F. Chang's, kids love Panda Express. You have a Red Onion. So a little bit of everything. As far as shopping, world-class shopping, you've got Chanel. You've got Tesla. You've got the Lincoln store there. As you can see, you have Neiman Marcus. Some people call it Needless Markup. But you have it, Neiman Marcus. You have a Bloomies, Bloomingdale's. You have all kinds of things. So nothing you really can't find there. A lot of hiking, a lot of trails. Highly recommend taking a look at them. Let me go back up here. These are the ones they recommend. Laguna Woods, a bit farther, but Cameo Highlands, definitely. The Crystal Cove Trail. Go to State Beach, State Park. You can park and you can walk underneath the road. So the Trancas, it's really cool. So Laurel Canyon, Laguna Woods, a lot of cool things. I'm gonna have a link to this. A lot of things to see and do. I'm also gonna have a link to this because it offers some really interesting information about, you know, frontage and size. And, you know, people ask, how many boats are in Newport Harbor? It's 4,300, it's 1,230 piers. Very cool. So I'm gonna have a link to this. People ask about new homes. There's only one new home development that I'm aware of right now. The others have sold. And this is a Shea Homes. And so this is at Marina Shores. I'm gonna, again, if you have any questions about that, certainly let me know. I have a few more things about beaches I'm gonna post. And this one I liked, familydestinationsguide.com. This one has better information about why they recommend it. And I like it. It offers a lot of good things. So, again, you can come and we used to play football here, and the beaches are absolutely fantastic. So here we are. We have four homes. And I certainly want you to watch our Newport Beach vlog, because we take you by these homes and we give you some really nice driving footage of the areas. So the first one's in Harbor View Homes. And this is called the Port Streets because every street there is named after a port. So Harbor View, East Bluff is the area. Harbor View is a subdivision. And as we've talked about, a lot of homes here have HOA. This is $115 a month. There's no Melrose. Beautiful home, has so many nice upgrades. And let me open up the picture. So 3,275,000, 3,574 square feet. All of our stats are right here. 3,275,000, recently reduced the price. You can see it's a 5-bedroom, 3.5 bath. So they're not in suite, not each bedroom has its own bathroom. 7,700 square foot lot, nice size lot. You can do a lot out there. They don't have a swimming pool, but a lot of the communities here have nice swimming pools. So it's, you know, a lot of people just don't, they don't always have pools. Built in 1969, again, no Melrose, which is an infrastructure bond. We see often, certainly in new homes, they have them, but none of the homes here are gonna have them. So let's take a look. You have a lot of neat things, beautiful flooring. This is a luxury vinyl plank. I really like it, and it wears well. And so we're starting to see more and more homes. I like the volume ceilings are really nice. As you can see, it's a nice open floor plan here. A lot of the homes over in the Port Streets, what people do is they buy them and they renovate them. So it's not unusual, as you're watching, for example, our driving footage, you'll see newer homes. People come in and they'll take it down to the studs, which is basically just one beam, and they'll build a new home. So for $3.275 million, most likely someone's going to buy this on a 7,700 square foot lot. They're going to go ahead and buy it. They're going to scrape it or take it down to the studs and just build basically a new home. As we see that a lot. So, but these are nice open floor plans. They've done a lot. They've painted. They've upgraded. Again, there's an open concept kitchen. We see that more and more, certainly in the new homes. But again, you've got the older tile. You're not going to have all the granites. You're not going to have the Caesar stone, which is quartz. You're just not going to have that everywhere. A lot of people will come in and they'll redo all of this. So you might use this, which is a downstairs bonus room, playroom. You might end up turning it into a media center, media room, home theater. But again, certainly could be a bedroom. I think they're counting four. The agent was counting four. This could be the fifth bedroom. But a lot of people are going to come in, and they're just not going to mess with changing the footprint, so to speak. They're just going to tear it down, and we see that a lot. So, but its current form, really, really nice. Nice, expansive bedroom, main. But again, you're not going to get granite. You're not going to get Caesar stone. And it's older, as you can see the framing and all. It's older. It is what it is. 1969. A lot of people come in, they're going to replace the carpet. This is a secondary bathroom, as you can see. There's the old saw mirrors. So that's what you get from 1969. But the location, it's in the Port Streets, has a lot of potential. 7,700 square foot lot. You can do a lot in the back. It needs work, but again, 3.275 million. So there's the private pool for the Harbor View homes. You have a clubhouse. You're not far from Fashion Island. You're close to a lot of things. Elementary school, Anderson. Oh, by the way, the weather in Newport Beach, an average about 70 degrees, so it's a bit cooler. And the schools, top-rated schools. So a lot of these schools are fairly close by. A lot of kids end up biking, walking, taking their electric scooters. We see a ton of them taking electric scooters, electric bikes. I don't know. Don't get as much exercise, but okay. So you have a Harbor View Homes, Greenbelt. As you can see, you have a tot lot. But a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful home. On the market, 3.275 million. 3,574 square feet. Let's go ahead and take a look at another home. Let's go ahead and let's go over to the Dover Shores area. Remember Dover Shores, you have Morning Star, Evening Star, Night Star. They actually have docks. And so Harbor, this is all part of Dover Shores. Now we're at almost 4.3 million. It's an older home, built in 1963. A lot of people coming in and they're gonna scrape it, they're gonna renovate. But more of a mid-century look. It's really nice look. We did, on our vlog, what you'll want to see, we were right in front of the home, and it's a very nice home. It's smaller, 2,528 square feet, but now it's in Dover Shores, so it's closer to the water. You're going to pay more, and the lot size is 8,532 square feet. A lot of cool things. Again, easy access to the Back Bay, yes, beaches. You can, just a lot, just so many things close by. You've got 17th Street. Here they've done a few things. Again, on the market, 4.295 million, four bedroom, four bath, 2,528 square feet, 8,532 square foot lot, and the HOA is zero. That's why people like Dover, this area of Dover Shores. So let's take a look. So let's take a look at the home. Walk in, got a nice courtyard. You have some very nice upgrades. You have the wide planks. This is nice. You have the pendant lighting, you have a very open, they've certainly renovated, very open kitchen, but you've got, here's a barn door, that's a big thing, so you can, oh, let me see if I can come over here, just have to get rid of it. The barn door was a big thing for a while, and it literally slides this way, so they're really cool. But they've carried this theme, they've carried that theme there, and so there's the barn door, so that gives you, this is the family room, family room. So, gives you an idea. So, dining area, again, a lot of nice upgrades. These, more and more, the older homes had the skylights. The problem with those is the seal. You gotta watch that, they'll leak. Even though we have 300 plus days of sunshine, when it rains, we have some problems. This home, large enough for pool, we'll go in the backyard. But a nice open concept. A lot of space. Caesar stones, they have the granite. They have a bigger range. And you're going to get a sub-zero. Plus, you're going to get a sub-zero storage for your wine. Pretty nice. That's the barn door that we looked at earlier. So that hides the laundry room. Nice secondary vanity. So we have the main, and it has very nice. Very nice. Very nice master main bedroom with, you have the shower, the tub. So all of this is the main. All of this is the main there. So the secondaries. Going to the back. And one of the things that I really like about this home, not just location, but it has a very nice, just a really big door to, sorry about that, big door to open up. So it's a melding of the inside, outside, and then you step in the pool. Low maintenance, really low, because you don't have to cut the grass. Barbecue, fire pit, nice home, Dover Shores. On the market, $4.295 million, four bedroom, four bath, 2,528 square feet. It's all right here. Oh, sorry about that. All right here. So let's go to home number three. Now, home number three is going to be on Harbor Isle. Oh, sorry about that. Harbor Isle. Harbor Island, sorry. So it's on Harbor Promontory Bay on Harbor Island. So just down the street from the client that we helped lease a property for a little while on the water. So this home, for almost $10 million, has 53 feet of water frontage. You can dock a 40-foot boat. It's four bedrooms, four and a half baths, 4,440 square feet. So four is a wild, 5,000 square foot lot. Not gonna need a pool, because when you get up in the morning, you can literally hop in your watercraft. You can kayak. You can get to almost anywhere from here. It's really cool. Built in 73. You're not far from Balboa Island, but you're here. And it's not gated. It's not guard gated. And a lot of people think, hey, for $10 million, I'm going to get a guard gated home. That's not the case in most of the homes in Newport. There are some guard gated communities, but they're fairly rare. But this is what you're paying $10 million for. It's this. On the water. Beautiful views. So you've got. And what's interesting is you do have an in-ground spa. They decided to put that back here, and that's interesting. But you've got the water. So a lot of neat things. One of the things that we talked about in our vlog, we talked about the master bathroom, which is very very nicely done bathroom. So this is again on the water. Boom. Water entrance, very stately, winding staircase, contemporary. Love the architecture. So something that you wouldn't think from a home that was built, you know. Let's go back to the builder, 70, built in 1973. You wouldn't think it's that contemporary, but this one is. Again, on the market for almost $10 million. Now you've got your granites, now you've got your Caesar stones. Look at this view from the main bedroom. Goodness gracious, look at that. Wake up to that. $10 million. Wonderful home, though. As an investment, someone's going to make some money on this. This is a view. Boom. Take your boat, head out the ocean. Main bathroom. Elegant. Really like this home. A lot going for it. Family room, game room upstairs. There's the secondary bedrooms. That's more of a Murphy bed. So actually pulls down. So there's your secondary bathrooms. There's a laundry. But make no mistake, you're buying a home because you're on the water. Bam. Straight out. Really nice home. A lot of great views. $10 million. Four bedrooms, four baths. 4,440 square feet. Next home, and the last one I promise, is on oceanfront on Balboa Peninsula. Wonderful home. Some really cool things here we're going to talk about. On the market for $15.995 million, this is called Toes in the Sand. This is the home. And you literally put your toes in the sand from your house, just outside your house. So there's great value there. One of the neat things about this home is there's no boardwalk in front of it. If you go down this way, go down that way, you're going to end up at Balboa Peninsula up here. And a lot of the homes have a boardwalk in front of it. I've lived on Balboa Peninsula. We used to rollerblade. You could ride your skateboard, your scooters, your bikes. We used to do all that. And so you're going to have a lot of the people doing that in front of your home. But down here, this is off M Street. Down here, you don't have that. So there's great value. If you value, if people value their privacy, they'll spend an extra few dollars. Now, one of the negatives is to get off the peninsula during summer is it can take a few hours. It is really bad. So I had a motorcycle. So 4 bedrooms, 4.5 baths. All the bedrooms have their own bathroom. 4,229 square feet. Smallish lot. Don't need a big lot. You're right on the ocean. 15.995 million. And here we have an HOA of 0. Naturally, there's no mellow roofs. Home was built in 2015. Someone came in, bought it, and built a new home. Says, there's your garage, 3-car garage. And there's your home. Put some grass in the front. Beautiful home. Sand. As you can see, there's the canal. There's Newport Beach. But this is your view. That's it. Over here's right here's something called the wedge. We'll talk about that. But absolutely fantastic. Fantastic home, fantastic community. There's so much to see and do. This home, again, is on the market for $15. Sorry about that. If you can cut that out. I thought it was charging. This home's on the market for $15.995 million. Absolutely fantastic home. You are about 30 feet from this view. This is the wedge. And it's dangerous. But absolutely fantastic home. You're in your living room. That's your view. Now, at night, you do have lights because you've got promontory. Someone said Fashion Island. I don't know Fashion Island. But you definitely have lights. You're going to see all the lights from the ships, but you also have some lights from... Certainly, you've got some other. Yeah, you're not far from the jetty, so the canal. You're going to see some things, but absolutely gorgeous home, contemporary. This is a floating staircase, so it's 3 floors. It's floating, really cool, and just a lot of neat things. This is a single block of marble. Wow. Beautiful. Contemporary. You got your Caesar stone. You're looking out. You can be in the tub of the water. Come up here. You got observation area. You can do all kinds of things with this room. Again, but it's the views. Make no mistake. The fact that you're on the water. So, nice little, you've got your barbecue area. You've got your TVs, you've got a fireplace, and you got the sunset, you got the views, the jetty, or sorry, the wedges this way. So, fantastic home. $15.995 million. These are heaters. Some people don't know these. So these are heaters. So when you come up, you've got your fireplace, you have the deck, so you can cook. The other side, you've got the city, sea light views, and this is the wedge. Here's the some of the waves in the wedge. Not a place you're going to swim, but definitely a place you're going to walk and enjoy. So, beautiful home. It's on oceanfront, Balboa Peninsula, on the market $15.995 million. So, thank you for joining us. I try to make these a little shorter, but it's tough. Newport Beach, wonderful city. So, if you have any questions, let me know. I'm going to have a lot of things I reference are going to be in the information below. But whether you're looking to make a move, in the next week, month, heck, the next year, I'd love to help you. Looking to sell? I'd love to help you there too. Give us a call, shoot us a text, send us an email. We would love to help you make a smooth move to Orange County, California.